Welcome back, toy fans, to this anniversary edition of Ronald's Reviews. On today's episode, we're going to take a full tour of the collection room. Cue the match. Welcome back, everyone. Now, like I said in the intro, today is a little bit of an anniversary edition of Ronald's Reviews, but we are also going to take a full room tour of the Ronald's Reviews base. Now, it's almost 3 years to the day that I've been on YouTube, and I just want to say in that time, I mean, what a 3 years it's been. You know, some of the friends I've made and the people I've met, it's just unbelievable. I never thought that this would happen when I started the channel, you know. But during that time, it's been around 10 months maybe since my last room tour, and the room has changed quite significantly in that time. If you follow the channel closely, you will know that the most notable change and the hardest change for me to make is what you see behind me.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
That's right, the Detolf cabinets that used to house all my 1.1 scale helmets has gone. It was a really difficult decision to make because it kind of felt like I was taking away a signature part of the room. But I do love my new setup. As you can see, the whole point was to try and get more stuff on display, which I have done that, but it was a really difficult decision to make. But not only has the room changed, but the channel has changed. You can argue the focus and direction of the channel has changed in that time. The channel was only ever meant to be a Star Wars channel. The room was only ever meant to be a Star Wars room, but I've been influenced by so many collectors and their collections that the collection is so much more diverse now. But like I said, also the appearance of the channel has changed. You know, the graphics, the intros, the outros, the scene changes, and that again is down to two very good friends of mine. I'm very lucky to be surrounded and supported by some amazing people, but we will talk a little bit more about that at the end of the video. So sit back, relax, put your feet up, grab a cuppa, and enjoy this full room tour of the Ronald's Reviews base. See you at the end. Okay, so as we enter the room, on the back of the door, we start with my Star Wars Retro Collection figures. Now, I've removed the stickers from the Star Wars ones. They didn't really offend me, but I took them off anyway, but I didn't bother with the rest of the wave. So I've got my Empire Strikes Back wave underneath there. And then as we go further down, we've got Mandalorian waves. So I think it was the Mandalorian and IG-11 was donated to me by Nick Action Pop Dad. And the rest were gifted to me by Jason over at Travels with Jason F. Thank you, boys. I really do appreciate it. Every channel, every YouTuber, and everyone that's got an Instagram page, etc., I will leave in the description afterwards. So please check it out. Every channel will be in there that I mentioned today. Then above the door, we've got my Rocky figures. Rocky's actually just starting to discolour. The package is going yellow there, which is really disappointing. And then we've got the other side, my NECA Rambo figures, bought for me by Rachel a while ago. They're bringing some money now, these. And then moving over, excuse the glare, everybody. We've got another Retro Collection Luke Bespin, because why not? And then we've got my prototype Boba Fett. We've got my ARC Trooper Echo. I won that on a competition from Steve-O collecting Star Wars. And then my Mithral, which was very kindly sent to me by Paul over at Paul's Collectibles. I will try and remember everything that everyone sent me, so please forgive me. I'm trying to remember everything in real time, where everything's come from. So please forgive me if I get to mention you or if I get any names wrong. I'm trying to remember it all as I go. So we've got the Blue Sky Boba Fett Vintage Collection there. Sorry about the glare, everybody. Then we've got the Imperial Death Trooper carbonized version. We've got my Remnant Stormtrooper, again sent to me by our Paul at Paul's Collectibles. Luke Skywalker X-Wing. I think that's the Saga collection, that one, actually. Then we've got my Death Trooper. No, Shadow Trooper. Sorry, Shadow Trooper. Imperial Stormtrooper. Boba Fett. And the Shaw Trooper. And then going down again, we've got Enfys Nest, First Order Stormtrooper, Leia in Boosh, and Luke in Stormtrooper outfit. I don't collect much vintage collection because it's just such a vast line, and I worry about getting behind and just, I don't have the room for it, but I do love it. And then under that, we've got my Master Replica lightsabers. We've got Luke Jedi, Kylo Ren, and Anakin from Attack of the Clones. Okay, so we're on the top shelf at the moment. Excuse my shaky hand cam. I'll do my best, but we've got my Black Series Luke Skywalker X-Wing helmet. And then we've got the Mandalorian. We've got the Shadow Trooper helmet. Then we've got my Bane mask and my Dark Knight cowl. Absolutely love those. And then we've got my Marvel Legends Star-Lord helmet, Iron Man. And then my Michael Myers mask. Not a massive horror fan, but Michael Myers is a huge, huge character that I love. Just a fantastic character. I really do like him. Big fan of that. And then I've got my Battle Drones, Star Wars Battle Drones. We've got Speeder Bike, X-Wing, and Darth Vader's TIE Fighter being taken care of by my Lego Buildable Scout Trooper and Speeder Bike there. And moving down, we've got my 1.1 scale Star Wars helmet. So we've got the AT-AT driver there. We've got Agent Miko from the Inferno Squad from Battlefront. And we've got Black Series Imperial Stormtrooper, as well as my TK Armor, a New Hope Imperial Stormtrooper helmet. Black Series Darth Vader helmet. Black Series Kylo Ren. That is very, very expensive now, by the way. I'm not quite sure why that's shot up in price, but I managed to get that just before Toys R Us went out of business, but really expensive now. And then we've got my Black Series First Order Stormtrooper and my Anovos First Order Stormtrooper helmet as well. Okay, I'm moving down. Please excuse the glare again. So we've got Star Wars shelf now. So as you can see, we've got Jabba and some of his goons there, the Max Rebo band. Obviously missing some accessories. Hopefully I'll pick them up as I go. You can see the podium at the end of Jabba's set is missing. Then at the back, we've got a lovely GW credit case with my Luke Bespin and card in. It's one of the cases where you can stand a loose figure at the front. A really good alternative to buying carded. I just can't afford those, so really good alternative. Then we've got, at the back, we've got my carbonized Boba Fett and 40th anniversary Black Series. Coming down, like I said, please excuse the glare. We've got my one and only vintage carded figure, very, very kindly sent to me as a gift by Matt over at Zero Hunter Toys. Thank you, Matt. Love that guy. And we've got another retro collection Boba Fett, just because I like it a lot. And then one piece I'm really pleased to have is my vintage collection Rocket Firing Boba Fett. Really pleased to get that. Behind there, if you can just see, we've got my vintage style Boba Fett shelf sign. Then we've got my Bounty Hunter capture log, very, very kindly sent to me by our Steve, better known as Lord Mulvada. Thank you, Steve. And then we've got various Boba Fett figures, because I love Boba Fett. So if we start at the bottom, we've got a couple of vintage, we've got one retro collection and a vintage version. We've then got, can't remember what version it is, the one on the second to the left, which was very kindly sent to me by Marcus Cofolo, a very good friend of the channel. And then at the end, my one and only bootleg Boba Fett, sent to me by Steve Derby Collector, who you will probably hear mentioned various times by the time this video is finished. Moving up, we've got Boba Fett on the far right, was very kindly sent to me by Paul over at Paul's Collectibles. The droids Boba Fett was sent to me by Michael Chapman. Very kind of you, Michael. And then we've got the Iconicon Boba Fett by Stan Solo. Absolutely love that. And then a loose prototype Boba Fett again. Moving up, we've got a few more of my vintage versions. So we've got a couple of Taiwan versions in there and another retro collection. And then right at the top, we've got a loose 40th anniversary Boba Fett with Han in Carbonite, and then my 6-inch droids Boba Fett, again, very, very kindly sent to me as a gift from our Smith Lord, Chris Smith. Absolutely love that guy. Sneaking in at the back, we've got my Lego Buildable Boba Fett. And then, of course, we've got my 1.1 scale custom Empire Strikes Back helmet there, and the Black Series Boba Fett helmet next to it. Next to that, we've got my vintage Kenner Star Destroyer playset, which is complete. As you can see, we've got Vader there giving instructions to Boba Fett and all the other guys at the back. We've got a couple of vintage speeder bikes there with the scout troopers. And behind that, we have got the lovely Star Wars Toy Guide Kenner action figure book from Johnny and Greg at Red 5 Designs. Boys, I apologise. I know you're not really meant to stand it up, but I just love how it displays and I just love it sat there. So hopefully it will be okay. But yeah, I know you're not really meant to, so I do apologise, boys, but I just love how it displays. Now we've got a little display stand with some Jedi figures on. We've got some Ewoks there, a couple of last 17 figures. The Stormy Luke was very, very kindly donated to me by our Baz. And then we've got some more Jedi figures. You may remember Baz, better known as I Am the Dave, always supports everybody. Yeah, so really happy with that. So now we come to what is fast becoming probably my favourite area of the room. So we are now onto my mask shelf. And there's a lot to get through, as you can see. So you can see a lot of my loose, I've got the bikes and the sort of smaller vehicles at this end. And as you can see, I've got a few items in the GW cases. So the T-Bob and Jungle Challenge Matt Tracker there are customs from my very good friend Ant. You'll remember Ant, he does the custom boxes and does a few carded as well. So those are customs from Ant. Love those. And we've got an original carded T-Bob and Scott Tracker. And probably one of my prized possessions in my mask collection is my original carded unpunched Miles Mayhem and Venom's Revenge. Very, very kindly sourced for me by Ron, a good friend of the channel. And he got me a great deal on that and then sent me all the way from America. Just above there, you can see, oh, again from Ron, I've got a boxed bullet or bandit, depending on where you are in the world. But that is in amazing condition, and Ron sent me that as a gift. Thank you, mate. Absolutely love that. Now we've got some of the custom boxes from Ant. We've got Condor and Thunderhawk there. As we go across, we've got an original Gator box. Oh, it's not. Sorry, that's one of the boxes from Ant. Sorry, they're so good. Then we've got the Mask Call Up Computer, the customized playset from Cliff Dagger. Do need to get that displayed. It's still in the box. I want to get it displayed properly, but just get in the room. And then as we move down, you will recall that this absolutely beautiful Rhino was sent to me by Andy over at the Holo Chronicles last Christmas. Absolutely beautiful example. Love it. And as promised, Andy, once I got my new setup, it would be front and center. So there you go. And as you can see, we've got Bruce and Matt Tracker there with their helmets. Helmets, masks, the masks. Sorry, God, my Facebook group would kill me if they heard me call them helmets. And Alex Sector and Buddy Hawks there with the short masks. And then, of course, Rhino, an absolutely beautiful example. Probably the best example I've ever seen with the chrome and stickers, everything missing. So thank you, Andy. I absolutely love that. Then moving along, as you can see, we've got the vehicles and figures displayed together. So we've got Thunderhawk there with Matt Tracker, Raven and Calhoun Burns. We've got Gator and Dusty Hayes. That is an absolutely beautiful Gator. Very kindly sent to me by our Chris Smith, again, better known as Smith Lord. Got my original Switchblade box at the back. Then as we move on, we've got Hondo McLean with Hurricane. Vanessa Warfield with Manta. And again, that is minty new. Very, very kindly sent to me by a good friend of the channel, and Dean from All Things 80s. Thank you, Dean. I love that. Then we've got Gloria Baker and Stiletto. Just behind there, we've got another beautiful box from Ant for Jackhammer and for Stinger. Then we've got Stinger just above there with Bruno Shepherd. Then we've got Jacques Lafleur with Detonator, Cliff Dagger and Jackhammer in the corner. We've then got Volcano. I don't have Volcano the vehicle, that's just the box, but hopefully I'm going to be adding Volcano very soon. And then we've got in the corner a boxed Meteor, again very kindly sent to me by Ron. But I also have a complete loose Meteor, again not on display at this point, but That was also gifted to me by, again, Chris Smith, Smith Lord, very generous guy, sends me a lot of stuff, very good of him. We've got an original firecracker box, and just behind there, an original slingshot box. We've then got firecracker with Hondo McLean, which is now complete with my custom short mask, very kindly sent to me by Mark, a good friend from Instagram. Then we've got Firefly and, oh my God, I forgot his name. Julio Lopez, my God, just completely had a mind blank there. We've then got Slingshot with Ace Riker. And then, of course, we've got my lovely Switchblade, very kindly gifted to me by Dave and DCB June. My custom Miles Mayhem there, sent to me from Dave Surridge. And that is an original Gator box. And I don't know if you can just see behind there, I've got my mask lunchbox from Bluebird, and it has got the flask inside that as well. Okay, so we're on to another one of my favourite shelves in the room now. I absolutely love my Transformers shelf. It is getting a bit overloaded now, but I do love it. So at the back, we'll start at the back with the reissue Headmasters. I do love the Headmasters. Hardhead is a favourite of mine. I'm looking to get a vintage Hardhead, but I've got the reissue. Then we've got my G1 Galvatron, very, very kindly repaired and restored with all its lights and sounds by our VTR Dave. Thank you, Dave. Then we've got some of Galvatron's minions. So we've got Scourge there and Cyclonus. Then we've got Thrust and Skywarp, a couple of the Seeker Jets. Skywarp, one of Shabby's favourites. And then we've got G1 Blur, very kindly sent to me by Tez. And then we've got G1 Soundwave with Ravage just at the bottom there. Just hiding at the back, we've got my G1 reissue Hot Rod. And I don't know if you can see it, just underneath Hot Rod is my G1 reissue Dinobot Grimlock, very kindly sent to me by Jody from Gen X Toys Geek. Thank you, Jody. Then moving along, we've got the commemorative edition Skywarp, Starscream just behind that. And then just sneaking in behind there, we've got the commemorative edition Red Alert. As you can see, it's very tight on this shelf. We've got my G1 reissue Optimus there, box for Soundwave. And then as we come down, we've got my movie version Hot Rod next to my Blu-ray Transformers movie. Just think they display great together, so I'll put them together. Sneaking in at the back is G1 Ultra Magnus. Excuse the glare again, everyone. We've got my Wheelie mini bot. I know nobody likes Wheelie. I really like him. I don't have any problem with it at all, but I know a lot of people don't like Wheelie. And then let's see if I can get rid of the glare. We've then got a couple of the 80s Transformers comics. So we've got issue number one and number two there. Issue number one, absolutely 100% Jeff Barker's fault. We're on a call once with Jeff, and he was showing off his unbelievable comic collection in Transformers number one. He was showing us, and I just thought I need to own one of those. So very lucky to get that. Just tucked in at the back, we've got a few of the Transformers Masterpiece. We've got Hot Rod there. I think the other two, I'm trying to remember who they are now. I think it's Wheeljack. It's Red Alert and Sideswipe. And then just getting further down, we've got my original carded Lionheart from Supernaturals. Again, very, very kindly gifted to me by Ron for Christmas this year. Thank you, Ron. I love that guy. I'm just waiting for a case to come for him. We've got my Tomb of Doom Supernaturals. Maybe going to a certain Mr. VTR Dave, that guy, because it does need a slight repair, and I'm hoping he can help me out with that. And then just next to that, we've got some loose Supernaturals in various stages of completion, but hopefully I will complete them all soon. But again, just another toy line that I have a real affection for from childhood. Okay, so getting to the bottom shelf now. As you can see, we've got poor old Castle Grayskull at the end there. Don't really have a proper home at the moment, but only a couple of bits missing, and then that will be complete. But yeah, unfortunately, it's just sat at the end for now, so not really displayed properly. Then we've got some storage boxes. They're just various different bits and pieces in these boxes, accessories, spare figures, etc. They're just there for storage. But then next to that, I finally managed to get myself a very, very nice Boulder Hill box. So my Boulder Hill is complete and boxed now. Big shout out to Sam Clay from Facebook. Did me a great deal on this, and I absolutely love it. The box is in great condition. Needed a little bit of restoration, but really cleaned up well, so very pleased to finally have a box to Boulder Hill. Then next to that, we have got my reissue Turtles Party Wagon and my vintage Party Wagon, which is now complete. Rachel was very kind enough to buy me that for Christmas, and then I managed to pick up a modern one or a reissue one recently. But these are absolutely 100% the fault of Ryan, the collector kid. Sorry, Ryan, it's true. I just found, not long ago, I found Ryan's channel, and he was just doing a huge haul of TMNT, and I saw the Party Wagon in a bit more detail on Ryan's channel and thought, yeah, I need to own one of those. So don't get me wrong, Ryan, don't be sorry, I absolutely love it, but 100% your fault. But talking about Aussies, next to that is my real Ghostbusters firehouse, and that is 100% the fault of Scott Crusher. So yeah, when I found Scott's channel, one of the first videos I watched was his video on the real Ghostbusters firehouse, and again, immediately kicked off that nostalgia and thought, yeah, I need to own one of those. So hugely influenced by the Aussie lads there, but thank you, boys, don't be sorry, because I love them. Then moving along, we've got a small shelf with a lot of my reference books, comics, annuals, sticker books, all on there. A lot of them sent to me by people like Retro Ed, Smith Lord, Emma, who I work with, sent me a couple, Monkey Boy Dave, Jason, Travels with Jason F. Sorry if I'm forgetting anybody, but never have too many comics and reference books. And then underneath, you've got my Star Wars Blueprints book, Masterpiece Soundwave, and then just tucked behind the firehouse, I've got my Augmented Reality Jedi Challenges game, which, again, is great fun. Okay, then moving along onto the next wall, we've got a few of my Star Wars pictures that I picked up at various Comic Cons. Then moving down, sorry about the glare again, we've got my Skeletor with Snake Mountain Funko. I'm not really happy with this shelf. I want to display it differently. It's just kind of a bit higgledy-piggledy at the moment, but I will rearrange this shelf. Then we've got my Mandalorian Retro Collection figures. Again, excuse the glare. And then at the end, we've got my very, very nice boxed Twin Pod Cloud Car. So the box itself was donated to me by Andy at the Holo Chronicles. Very, very kind of you, Andy. Thank you. But inside the box is also my vintage Cloud Car, very kindly gifted to me by Matt over at Keep On Collecting. Absolutely lovely. It was a lovely story behind it as well. So that is wrapped up nice and safe and sound in the box. So yeah, I will never ever part with this. Thank you, Matt. And then moving down, I've got my vintage consoles. So I've got my Mega Drive there, not my childhood version, unfortunately, but love my Mega Drive. Got my PS1. Obviously, Xbox One isn't vintage, but I love playing Battlefront on the Xbox One. And then I've got my SNES, which I do every so often enjoy a little bit of NBA Jam and Mario Kart and things like that. And then we've got my Motu shelf, or one of my Motu shelves, and I do enjoy displaying the carded Origins figures behind my vintage figures. So as you can see, I've got various vintage figures in front. I tried to match up the vintage figures with the Origins version at the back. So as you can see, I've got Webstar together there, He-Man and Skeletor together. Then we've got my Landshark. Absolutely love that thing. And then same at this side. Tried to put some vintage figures with their Origins counterparts. I've got my carded Trapjaw there, very kindly sent to me by our Connor Fuller over at Fuller's Figures. Great channel, check it out again. Everyone I mention will be in the description afterwards. We've got Faker, Stinkor, Stratos, and then right at the end, we've got my Origins Scareglow, again, very kindly donated to me by Chris Mewer from Chasing 80s Toys. Amazing channel, again, check it out. I'm sorry, everybody, by the way, if you're listening to my voice and thinking that sounded a bit different. A virus has ripped through our house in the last couple of weeks, and we're all just struggling to shake it off. So if my voice sounds a bit rough, I do apologise. I'm still a tiny bit under the weather and just trying to get through the video. So, yeah, hopefully it's not spoiling your enjoyment. And then bottom shelf, we've got my carded Droids figures, obviously reissues. We've got my boxed Palutoy Imperial Troop Transport. 40th anniversary Wumper. And then we've got the Hoth Ice Planet adventure game with Snow Speeder Loop from the Retro Collection. We've then got the Escape from the Death Star with Retro Collection Tarkin. And then just behind that is the box for my Vintage Collection Skiff. Okay, moving along. So as you can see, right on the top shelf in this corner now, we've got my vintage VHS Star Wars tapes. A few of them were my own from childhood, but I had one just there, the Classic Creatures sent to me by VTR Dave, only very recently. And then the rest were sent to me by Gary Moore, a very good friend of the channel. I need a better way to display these, but again, I'm just struggling for space. So I absolutely love my vintage Star Wars tapes. Just behind that, we've got the 2005 Star Wars diorama from Pride Displays, very kindly sent to me by Neil Grandin. My vintage X-Wing. We've got my Boba Fett helmet signed by Jeremy Bullock there. And then on this side, we've got my Lego Jabba's sail badge and skiff with the Sarlacc pit. And again, needs to be displayed a bit more optimal, but at the moment, space is the issue. Moving down, we've got my now Palatoy Return of the Jedi boxed and complete Rebel Transport. Absolutely love that thing. Then in this corner, we've got my Sphero BB-8 and R2-D2 with the Force Bands. We've then got one of my boxed speeder bikes. Got my vintage AT-ST at the back there. Then we've got my 40th anniversary Black Series Luke Bespin and Dagobah Luke, or Training Luke, whatever you want to call him. And then just next to him, we've got my Kyber Crystal, very, very kindly sent to me by Matt over at Matt's Collection, all the way from Galaxy's Edge. Very pleased to have that. And then we have got my boxed Slave One, which I am very, very proud to have. Absolutely love that thing. Moving down again, we've got the box for my Vintage Collection Slave One. Then we've got a loose carbonized Boba Fett, which actually won on Matt's channel, Zero Hunter Toys. Thank you, Matt. Behind that, we've got a boxed tripod mini rig, tripod laser cannon. And then in the corner, we have got my, this is not an original, there's no way I could afford an original, but we've got my replica Cloud City playset. And then on the next shelf, we've got my vintage collection skiff populated with some of my vintage figures. And behind that, they're not really connected, but we've got my carbonized Mandalorian. We've got Black Series Luke and Han. Black Series Training Luke with Yoda. And then we've got some loose 40th anniversary Black Series Snowtrooper and Attack Driver. I have just moved on some of my modern Black Series Empire Strikes Back figures, but those two I wanted to keep. I didn't want to part with those. I thought they just display great. So yeah, love those. And moving down again, we've got my boxed Scout Walker. And then we've got my boxed Snow Speeder at the back there. Palatoy Hoth Wumper. And then my second boxed speeder bike, very, very kindly gifted to me by Nick, better known as Action Pop Dad. Then we get to one of my favourite shelves in the room. So we've got my Luke Bespin Army. There are some more Luke Bespins to go in here. Very kindly sent to me recently by Chris D. Marcus Kafola has donated one as well. I know other people have donated them. So thank you to everyone that has added to the Luke Bespin Army. We've then got my Early Bird certificate package. But this is the, I think it was 2005. This is not the vintage one. I could never afford that. Then we've got my original 12 display stand with all the original 12 figures on. Very, very proud of this piece. It was my grail piece at one point. Luckily, I managed to acquire it. And then just some more random figures at this end. But I think the Luke Bespin Army is going to start coming down this side now as well. So moving down again, we've got my boxed Attack. Now the Attack is incomplete, but it is in there. I'm slowly but surely starting to put bits together and try and complete it with the help of people like Des T. Thank you, Des. He's just donated a part, so thank you. But love that. And then moving along again, another shelf that I absolutely love in the room, my Back to the Future shelf. So as you can see, we've got my Sports Almanac there. the boxes to my NECA figures. My Back to the Future 2 reaction figure is Griff. It's the only one I've got, but I absolutely love that. Recently gifted to me by the lovely Helen and DTM Dave. Then we've got my NECA Marty McFly figures there with the Out of Time number plate at the back. Got my custom hoverboard that I actually made myself. I'm really proud of that. And then we've got Marty McFly's wallet with all his ID in. We've got the Lego Brickheads, Marty and Doc. And then a very cool Back to the Future wax pack donated to me by Usual Mike, very good friend of the channel, another Aussie friend. We've got loads of Aussie friends in the community. And then, of course, my Nike Air Mags, which are a bit of a standout piece of my Back to the Future collection. Very proud to have those. Moving down again, we've got my Ghostbusters shelf now. So we've got my original vintage Slimer, Ecto-1. Ecto-1 is complete as well. We've got Mr. Stay Puft at the back there, some original Ooze. We've got Janine. Then we've got my Ghostbusters wax pack, again, very kindly sent to me by our Eddie over at Infinity Toys OKC. And we've got all the four original real Ghostbusters guys there with their ghosts. And then behind there, we've got my boxed Ecto 2. And then behind that, we've got my boxed Cooper Ghost, which Steve Darby Collector did me a great deal on. And then we've got some of the ghouls, which I always want to say Ghostman Pat for that guy, but that's not his real name, is it? It's just what Dave calls him on Vintage Toy Rush. I think it's just called Male Ghost, is he? Then we've got Airborne and, is it Ghost Granny? Or I can't think of the names, but yeah. Love my Ghostbusters shelf. And then we get to quite a new shelf in the room. So it's my TMNT shelf. So I've got the reissue Four Brothers at the back there. And then I've got some of the vintage figures. So I've got my Foot Soldier there again. Got a great deal with that guy from Derby Collector. This well, in fact, I think he got me all these actually. Same as Bebop and Rocksteady. And we've got Casey Jones and the Four Brothers. I'm going to add a few more to this, I think. I'm really enjoying the Turtles figures at the moment. And then again, some very cool wax packs at the back from Eddie, Infinity Toys OKC. He loves the wax pack. But yeah, I'm really enjoying TMNT at the moment, so probably going to add a few more. Maybe pick up Shredder, Splinter. I do like Baxter Stockman as well. So, and then moving down to the ground floor, again, a line that I'm loving at the moment. So as you can see, we've got my Fort Kerrion play set with Handlebar there, Marshall Bravestar himself, and then we've got Tex Hex with Outlaw Scuzz. And I absolutely love this line. Like I said, the bigger figures I'm really into at the moment. But yeah, really, really pleased with my collection with Bravestar right now. Again, huge thanks to Derby Collector. He sourced pretty much all these figures again for me. He's what a great guy he is. Really helps me out a lot. Okay, as we carry on, we've got my remote control R2-D2 there. And then we'll get into a few DVDs. So generally stuff that I watch the most. So down there, we've got my Transformers collection, a few Transformers movies, my Mask DVDs there, and my Thundercats box set, which I'm still waiting to crack open, but that was very kindly sent to me by Nick, again over at APD. Thank you, Nick. Move up, we've got a few Funkos. Again, I don't generally chase Funko Pops, but the ones I do get, I always really like, because they're always really great characters from movies that I love. So when they get bought for me for gifts, the people that buy me them always do pick out really good characters. So always happy to have those. And moving up, sorry, we're near the window now, so we'll be getting a bit bright. We've got my Vintage Collection Slave 1. And then just behind my work phone there, we've got Sydney Dean and Billy Hoyle from White Men Can't Jump. Love that movie. Carrying on, again, more DVDs. Again, generally ones that I watch the most. I don't actually watch that much Marvel stuff anymore, but obviously I watch the Star Wars films fairly regular. Even now, always watch Empire Strikes Back, somewhere in the background. And then my vintage Darth Vader carry case. some DVDs behind there, and then we've got my on-air light. The idea was to put the on-air light behind me whenever I do live streams with people, but I can never find anywhere for it to sit and plug in. And so I really do like that, and I want to use it, but I just haven't had the opportunity yet. And then next to that, we've got, you can't see them, but there is two vintage vinyl Star Wars carry cases there. Then moving up, we've got my Lego Boba Fett head, very kindly bought for me by DCB June and VTR Dave for Christmas. Got my TIE Fighter desk light. And then as we carry on, in the tote bins there, you can see that my Stormtrooper armor is tucked away in there. And then as we move up, we've got three carry cases there that generally hold my spare Star Wars figures. We've got a remnant Stormtrooper there waiting for a home. Nowhere for him to go yet. So, and then as we move up, my printer that I use for work, not interesting at all. Then we've got my carry case for my spare mask figures and accessories and masks, etc. Then moving up, we've got my Boba Fett Empire Strikes Back Cloud City Ollie Moss inspired picture there. And then as we go further up, we have got the lovely Rachel, hand drawn by our side, better known as Manga Fandanga, in Boba Fett armor. Absolutely love that. Pride of place in the base. Then carrying on, one of my favourite shelves in the room at the moment is my Centurion shelf. Now, there is a little bit of space on it, but as you can see, I've got Jake Rockwell there, Ace McCloud, Max Ray, then Doc Terror and Hacker at the back. We've got Jake Rockwell, very, very kindly sourced for me by Jani at Red 5 Designs. Then we've got Ace McCloud, who was sent to me as a gift by our VTR Dave. Didn't need a little bit of restoration, but really happy to get him. And then Max Ray, and then Doctor and Hacker at the back there. I also picked up a carded power pack from eBay. I got it like for 12 quid. So a really nice little purchase there for the Centurion shelf. And then a laser fire backpack for Bravestar, which is unopened and still unpunched as well. And I've got little Dave Vader to thank for that. Very, very good friend of the channel. He's actually a local guy, and he tipped me off on that. So it still needs a proper home, but really pleased to get that. Then moving up onto the next shelf, we've got my Coleco Rambo figures. Various stages of completion. Most of them are very, very close to being complete. If they aren't complete, only need the odd accessory here and there. And then, as you can see, Colonel Troutman there recently, so recent, in fact, it was only Echo a few weeks ago that was gifted to me by VTR Dave. It's a figure that I've been looking at recently as well, and then he handed that to me, Echo. So thank you, Dave. Love that guy. And we've got my 6-inch 18 figures. Again, almost all of them complete. I think Hannibal, is Hannibal missing? I'm not sure if Hannibal's missing a rifle, but Murdoch is missing his binoculars. Actually, I think they might all be complete, barring Murdoch's binoculars there. I think a couple of the rifles need straps, but other than that, really happy with those. And then we've got Sheldon and his equations board. Slythe from the Thundercats is helping him out there. And then at the back, we've got Jesus Quintana and the dude from one of my favourite movies, The Big Lebowski. And then moving up onto my Thundercats shelf, we have got a fully functional and complete vintage Thunder Tank, which I'm very proud of. Even got original tracks thanks to Steve Darby Collector. I think the next time I do a room tour, I'm going to do a sort of thanks counter for Darby Collector in the top corner. Just see how many times I've got to say thank you to him. He helps me out so much. Then we've got Snarf there, Tigra, Chitara Lion-O, Panthro Mumra. We've got Groon sneaking in at the back. The Tusker Warrior, not Walrus Man, everybody. And then Lynxo in the top corner as well. And then moving up again to the last shelf, we've got my Motor Origins Castle Grayskull. Still not opened it. I just love it in the box. So it displays great, so I think I'm going to leave it in its original box. Then moving down, we've got another Motu shelf. So we've got my Battle Armor Origins He-Man next to his vintage counterpart there. The Reynolds Review shelf sign. And then we've got vintage Battle Armor Skeletor next to the Origins Battle Armor Skeletor. We've got Panthor creeping in at the back, Anti-Eternia He-Man, and then Battlecat creeping in at the back at that side as well. Moving up, we've got a few shallow shelves just with some loose Star Wars figures, some of them beaters, but I just think they display nicely all on the shelf together. And then as we go further up, we've got my framed vintage Star Wars checklist, which Rachel bought for me a few Christmases ago now. I just love it for reference, and I just think it's really cool on the wall. Then moving on, we've got another Motu shelf. Now, I always think my Motu's scattered around, so we've got some more vintage Motu on there. But I'd like to get it all together, really. It's scattered around on different shelves, and I just feel I'd like to display it a bit more optimal, but it'll have to do for now. Then moving up, we've got my Playmobil shelf now. Only very small display Playmobil. There may be something new coming in Playmobil soon, though, so keep an eye on the channel. But we've got my Back to the Future Playmobil with the DeLorean. And then we've got the 18 boys there with the 18 van. I just love Playmobil, especially the 80s sets. I just think they're so good, so accurate. The attention to detail on the vehicles is great. And yeah, there may be something else coming soon. Going up, we've got more Motu. So we've got a fully functional and complete attack track there. A few figures at the back, Hordak in the middle there. And then we've got good old Whiplash on the battle ram. And then finally to finish, I'm very, very proud of my boxed original Snake Mountain. Now, Snake Mountain itself does need a few bits to complete it, but the box is original. Look how bright it is as well. It's such good condition. The original instructions are in there as well. So hopefully once that's complete, that will be a real standout piece in the room. And just to finish, I do tend to snore, so sometimes Rachel does tend to kick me out of the main bedroom. But if you're going to sleep anywhere once you've been kicked out of the main bedroom, where do you want to sleep? You want to sleep in your toy room, in your Star Wars bed, don't you? So we've got some vintage Return of the Jedi bedding there. And this is where I reside when I get kicked out of the main bedroom. But, hey, it's worth it. So there we go, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that, and I hope it's given you a good idea of what the room looks like at the moment, the layout and the changes that have been made. As you can see, we are jam-packed full, so I am in a situation where it's a one-in, one-out situation now, which I think going forward is going to be very difficult, but I hope you enjoyed that. So there we go, everybody. But before I carry on, I just want to apologise if my voiceover audio was a little bit hard on the ears in certain parts of that video. When I watched it back, my audio just seemed a little bit sharp in certain areas, so I apologise. I hope that didn't affect your enjoyment of the video. But like I said at the start of the video, I just want to give some thanks. I am very, very lucky to be surrounded and supported by so many people. I'm very, very lucky that way. Too many people to mention everybody's names, but I do just want to mention three guys, and I'm sure they know who they are. The ZSR boys, Shabby, Tez and Matt. Ever since our paths crossed right at the start of my journey on YouTube, 3 years ago roughly now, they took me under their wing, and they have been an ever-present avenue of support ever since. Not only have they supported me and given me advice on YouTube, but on a personal level as well. And I just want to say thank you, boys. You know, I probably wouldn't be sat here now if it weren't for you guys. But I also want to thank everyone else, because like I said, I do get so much support from so many other people. It really is quite unbelievable. But the biggest thanks possibly have to go to you guys, the viewers and the subscribers, everybody that takes the time out to watch Reynolds Reviews every week. You know, it staggers me that people still watch, you know, comment, and people have even recently been in touch to say that watching a Reynolds Reviews episode now is part of their Sunday routine, and I just find that mind-blowing. So I just want to say thank you to every subscriber, every viewer, and everyone that takes time out to watch the channel, because I can make all the videos in the world, but if you guys didn't watch, the channel would not exist, and that is not an exaggeration. So thank you to everybody that watches and supports Reynolds Reviews. I know I say it every week, but I really do appreciate it. So let's say it again. There we go, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by and giving me a shot. I hope you'll consider leaving a like and subscribing. And if you're one of my existing viewers and existing subscribers, thank you for sticking with me, everyone. I really do appreciate it. Leave any comments or questions in the comment section below. I always try to read everyone's comments and get back to everybody. And as always, keep collecting. I'll see you next time.